out of the world.
But you keep in touch. You email each other once a week or so. And at the end of every email, you say, I love you. I miss you. Please come home. After many years of this, one day you get an email from your friend. He says, I have some business going to take me through your area, and I was wondering if I could see you. So on the day your friend is coming to visit, you drive 3 hours to the big airport, and you stand there outside security by the baggage claim, and you wait. And all these people are coming through the doors, and you think, well, maybe there's a problem. Maybe I got the date wrong. But then, way back, at the back of this river of people, you see your friend. And oh, how your heart feels. You see, the Bible is not a rule book. The Bible is not a bunch of myths. It's not even a work of literature. And it certainly isn't something to be banging people over the head with. The Bible, praise God, is like a bunch of emails from the best friend you ever had saying, I love you, I miss you, please come home.
And my lips are in the darkness. I remember mama's words.
Now, I don't know who I'm preaching to today. Maybe I'm preaching to myself. But if there's anybody out there today who's thinking, I want to come home. I'm so tired of being out there by myself, fighting by myself. I just want to go home and see my friend. Well, I'm here to tell you, come on home. Come down here, because Jesus wants to welcome you home. Come on. Come on down here. Come on down here. Come on while there's still time.
Take me to the river.
Come on. Come on down. Come on down here. That's right. Come on.
Take my
hand. Oh, come on.
Take me to the river.
You know how this works, Gigi. Just pray with me, child. Mm-hmm. Heavenly Father, we thank thee.
Take me.
Welcome home, baby.